Hello friends, this is Priyanka. Today we are going to solve a problem on dynamics of fluid flow. In this video, we are going to determine what is the rate of flow in horizontal venturimeter. So first, I will read what is the given problem. A horizontal venturimeter with inlet and throat diameters 30 cm and 15 cm respectively is used to measure the flow of water. The reading of differential manometer connected to inlet and throat is 20 cm of mercury. Determine the rate of flow. Take CD, that is coefficient of venturimeter, is equal to 0.98. So this was the given question. Let us first understand the diagram as per the given data. So here we have to draw horizontal venturimeter. So we will consider the section 1 at inlet and section 2 at throat. Now the diameter at inlet, that is D1, is equal to 30 cm and diameter at throat, that is D2, is equal to 15 cm is given and we have to plot. Again, the coefficient of venturimeter is also given, that is CD is equal to 0.98. Now, if we observe, reading of differential manometer is given. So, that is the level difference of heavier liquid in U-tube. So, here X is equal to 20 cm of mercury. Now, if we observe here in this U-tube manometer, the mercury is there. And here water flow is there. So we come to know that from this structure that here is the heavier liquid and this is the level difference of the heavier liquid is given, that is 20 cm of mercury. So we have to find out what is the pressure head difference. So what is the pressure head? So pressure head at section 1, that is P1 by rho g, and at section 2 P2 by rho g. So we have to apply Bernoulli's equation for this venturimeter. And what is the Bernoulli's equation? That is pressure head plus kinetic head plus datum head is there. So we are going to equate the pressure head plus kinetic head plus datum head at section 1 and section 2. But if we observe, this is the horizontal venturimeter, so Z1 is equal to Z2. Now to calculate the flow rate in through venturimeter, that is Q, we have to calculate this H, because what is the formula for the discharge through venturimeter? That is Q is equal to CD A1 A2 divided by under root of A1 square minus A2 square under root of 2GH. That means we have to calculate first H. And what is H? That is the difference of pressure head. That is pressure head at point 1 P1 by rho g minus pressure head at point 2, that is P2 by rho g. So we can say that H is equal to P1 minus P2 divided by rho g. So what is the formula for H? So here the value of X is given and here mercury is heavier liquid than water. So we are going to use formula H is equal to X SH by SO minus 1. Now what is this SH? Because H suffix is used for the heavier liquid. So we have to put here specific gravity of heavier liquid and divided by specific gravity of the liquid through pipe, or we can say lighter liquid. So what is the specific gravity of mercury? So we know that it is 13.6. And what is the specific gravity of water? That is 1. So we have to put value. Now suppose here lighter liquid is there, then what will be the formula to calculate H? So here instead of H we have to use here L because of lighter liquid, and our formula will be H is equal to X into bracket 1 minus SL by SO. That is, we have to take here 1 minus because of lighter liquid. But here in this case, mercury, that is heavier liquid, is there. So when we calculate, we will get H is equal to 252 cm of water. Now why unit is centimeter? Because here X, that is 20 cm, we have taken here as it is. So our unit will be also in centimeter. Now we will calculate A1 and A2, that is the area at this section 1 and area at this section 2. Now we know that this is the cross section area and diameter is given. So what is A1? That is pi by 4 D1 square. So D1 is in centimeter. So what is pi by 4 30 square? That is 706.85 centimeter square. Then in the same way A2 is equal to pi by 4 D2 square, that is pi by 4 into 15 square, which is equal to 176.7 centimeter square. So in this way we get the values of A1, A2, CD is given, G means 9.81 and H that is equal to 252 centimeters. So if we observe, all the values are in centimeter. So we have to remember that is all the values should have same unit. So here we have to put all the values, then we have to calculate this. So after calculation we will get here discharge, that is 125,756 centimeter cube per second. So this is the answer. Now we can convert this into liter per second. So how to convert? So suppose there is centimeter cube per second, then we have to multiply here with 10⁻³. So we have to take here three digits to the left hand side. So 125.756 liter per second. So this is the answer. That is the discharge through venturimeter.